Hello, this video is about builds for the Zarin. Zarin? I don't know, you tell me. Anyway, these sub-topics are all linked in the description. She's quite a strong frame, because I was able to achieve with a melee Zarin wave 18 the Chura with a pickup group while leveling her. So I think that says quite something about her. And yes, melee is viable, especially against infested. If you don't believe me, watch the video at the end, where I prove it to you. Yes, one of the things you have to keep in mind is the passive ability, which increases the status effects, so you should gear around that. So you should choose a weapon with a high status chance, which can be good for CC or damage. Lots of the infested weapons are good, like the Torrid, the Pox, the Sakti, the Legion, the Miles. Especially the melee weapons are good because melee is quite strong and gets supported with her abilities. Because if you put condition overload in and have increased ability status duration, it gets even stronger. Yes. Let's talk about the arcanes. I have on the cloak the energize, because she's a caster and it's a lazy good choice. On the helmet I got nothing. The Chlora helmet has negative duration, which was quite OP back in the days with the old builds, but now it's wasted. The Hemlock helm has speed and negative HP. Well, you may use that for Exterminate, where you can use her, but in the end she's good in the endless mission, so yeah. Most likely, if you have enough energize, put it on the helmet as well. And let's get on to the focus. What focus you should use. I like melee playing with her. It's quite fun and strong. Which, yeah, and the standard melee option is Nerumon. If you're going for damage, you can take Madurai or the standard choice, Venuric, for energy. In general, she's something between support, damage, and CC. So let's go to the builds. The first one is balanced. We have a good range and a good duration to spread the procs, but also a good damage to keep all her abilities viable, so and we sacrifice the efficiency. The damage build, we aim for a higher strength while not sacrificing too much range and duration. Again, efficiency gets it. You can go up to 324 with two more formers. One would be here, 15 strength here, and growing power in there, another 24. And then we have the duration build. This focus, as the name says, on high duration with a good range and not gimping the strength too much. And again, sacrificing the efficiency. Yes, in general, you should also look at the augment mods for her. Some are quite good, that is not bad, this is also not bad, that's bad, but yes, that's good defensive-wise, and that helps you spreading the toxin around with the help of your teammates. But yes, let's get on to the balance build. The first focus is range with stretch and overextended. Yes, you can use max range, but with this combo and this former count, this happens to be just right. But in the end, yes, you can max it and put in more range here or something else what you desire, or strength. Then we want a good duration, so we take continuity and constitution. The other one has a negative factor, so we don't take that, which would be, yes, never mind it, which costs too much rain, so we don't take it. We still want a good damage, so we choose Intensify and Blind Rage. You can even get away with all combination of the mods. Intensify, Blind Rage, and Transient Fortitude, how you desire it. If you put in a near max Blind Rage, you get the clear 50% there. Yes, let's get on to the energy. We don't need to cast that often, because you cast this spore once, and thanks to the good duration and the range, they spread like crazy. And the other abilities only need to cast now and then, so putting in Prime Flow and having 850 energy is enough. Also, we have the cloak, and you can even go for Cenuric or something like that if you need even more energy. This is the defensive slot. You can put all the defense stuff in here, like Prime Vigor, Vitality, Redirection, Quick Thinking, or you can sacrifice the defensive slot for more offensive abilities. This one is also quite debatable. I choose this because it fits, but in the end, yes, this frame needs one more former and most likely another former for the aura slot. Here in that slot you can put all the Exilos mods if you don't like that. You can get more range, more strength, or more quality of life features, or whatever you desire. Another thing could be this one with the increased toxin damage on bullet jump. Combine that with a strong hitting weapon like Lanka, and you get really hard hitting toxin procs, which you can spread with your spores. But here's put in what you like. This slot is also very hard. If you don't want to sacrifice a former and change it, rejuvenation is quite good. If you want to change it, you have two routes. You can put in a Madurai, yes, a Madurai, and socket in the growing power. Since it's a very status heavy frame, you should have it up constantly, so you gain the 25% ability strength. The downside is you normally change it to Narumon and put in enemy radar, which I quite like, and if you're going against high level Grineer, the corrosive projection, which is quite standard. And if you have modded it to V for growing power and you need to put in CP, you get into problems. So yeah, you have to decide. And those are the three options for the aura slot. Now, commencing to the damage build, the focus is on the damage, as said. Prime Rage intensifies my choice, but if you... and naturally Transient Fortitude the choices. If you want more, as said, strength go can put in 15% more strength in here and 25 in there. Both cost you a former. Yes, and we don't want too bad range, so we have stretch in here, and you can go for overextended, but that will get your power strength down, so I chose this mod, but it's up to you. If you say, I want strength is good, but I want a bit higher range, then you can go for overextended, or you can throw this mod out and get 15% more range in that, or strength. It's up to you. And then this costs us some duration, but still, duration is somewhat important, so we have to take the prime continuity for the duration. Again, energy wise, it's an energy frame, so we take prime flow. It's a caster frame. We take prime flow because we have to do something about our energy efficiency, because it's quite bad from the rage. Then we have again the defensive slot. You can put everything and anything in there, or the defensive mod, quick thinking, redirection, vitality, vigor. And since it's a quite tanky frame for a caster with good HP and armor, that's why I chose the health in there. Also helps with the poison attacks of infested. If you choose just redirection, they will get around your shields easily. Yes, the same thing applies here. If you don't want to sacrifice a former, you stay with rejuvenation. If you want to use a former, you can go for Madurai and the growing power, or you can socket it to Naramon and put in the enemy radar, CP, and the standard stuff, which is again up to you. If you here you can mod that slot too, which will cost you another former. Again, the same things apply. I like this mod, also it fills up the capacity quite well. But again, all the Ixie Elos mods apply. Toxic, Flight, Cunning Drift for the range, Power Strength here for the utility or whatever you desire. Then, going to the Duration build. This is more leisure. The high duration and high range help you to reach the enemies easily, but you sacrifice the strength. Yeah, for the range, we take all the mods we can get. That's why the strength goes down, and for the duration, we also take all the mods we can get. But sadly, this includes narrow-minded, which increases the duration quite well, but also hampers our ability range. But as you can see, it's still above 200, so it isn't that bad. And even if you took out one or even those two mods, it wouldn't be that bad. So yeah, if you don't like those two, you can change them. Because this is in the defensive slot, if you want defensive stuff in here, then you throw out this mod. Again, we have to do something for the efficiency, so we use Prime Flow with Energize on the cape. And if that isn't enough for you, you can go for the Lenuric. And that the strength isn't too bad. We take, or at least I take Prime Rage. Yes, you can take the maximum. But I like the even number here. But if that's not your thing, you can put in Transient Fortitude, the Max Range, Blind Rage, or... Where is it? The Intensify, depending on your liking. Here I like the Ability Range, but again, you can put all the Exilus mods, and the interesting ones would be again Toxic Flight and Cunning Drift, Power Drift, Speed Drift, something like that. Yes, and the aura is again the same. If you don't want to mod it, you take Rejuvenation. If you want to mod it, you can go for Growing Power. If you use a V Polarity or you use a Dash for the enemy radar, CP, standard style. So yeah, let's see it in action. As I said, if you choose the weapon correctly, you can have quite some fun with here. These are quite high level enemies. You throw them with toxin radiation. The toxin is for the damage of your spores, and the radiation CCs the enemies. But the cool thing is they attack each other, causing them damage. You can see they spread the spores to the other groups as well. That's the cool thing. But the radiation is the radiation. They are not only CC'd, but also proc the spores and help spread it again and again. So as long as you keep throwing a spore from time to time at them, they will be CC'd. As you can see, 20... Oh! There's one that got away. But yeah, normally you don't fight 20 level 150 corpus techs at once. also you have teamwork to help you out a bit. But there are also very strong melee builds, like for the Mios with the Condition Overlord, as I said, if you want to have a more damage orientated approach. Yes, I hope this helps to find your own builds for your Saren. If you want to help me, subscribe and share. If I forgot something, please let me know in the comments, and I will append to this the video of the runs I had with Saren, and until next time.